the king of the one-liners, Henny Youngman.
What a crowd. If I had blood, I'd blush. I'm so happy to be here. First of all, I'd like to thank the management here for being so nice to me. It gave me a lovely dressing room, a nail. I just came back from London. I was there for a month. 6 hours difference in sleep, and I haven't slept yet. My timing is still off. I sit down to eat, I get sexy, I go to bed, I get hungry. I was just in Hollywood, they called up, they said, how much would you want to do a picture with Farrah Fawcett? I said, $50,000. They called back, they said, how about $20,000? I said, I'll pay it. She dressed in one room, I dressed in the next room. There was a little hole in the wall. I let her look. It's like a house party. I love this. While I was out there, I made a Jewish porno. 10% sex, 90% guilt. Now, the first scene, we see a priest. They send him up to Alaska. The priest is there a year. Nobody hears from him. So the bishop goes up to see him and says, how do you like it up here? He says, Bishop, if it wasn't for my rosary and 2 martinis a day, I would hate it here. He said, Bishop, would you like a martini? He says, yeah. Rosary, get the bishop a martini. Now, in the next scene, I was sitting in a bar, and fellow next to me fell off the seat 3 times. I picked him up, put him back. I said, I'll do a little good deed. I'll get this fellow home. Bartender, where does this man live? 8 blocks from here. So I grab the guy under my arm. I bring him out. I get in the taxi. He falls down. I get him home. I knock on the door. Mrs. Leopoldi, I brought your husband home. She says, where's his wheelchair? I love this crowd. Oh, that Hollywood is murder. The doctors. Oh, those doctors. I went to one while he was examining me. He grabbed me by the wallet and he said, cough. Wonderful doctor. Gave a man 6 months to live, couldn't pay his bill, gave him another 6 months. Doctor called a lady, Mrs. Cohn, your check came back. She says, yes, so did my arthritis. A little man walks in the doctor, says, doctor, I have a ringing in my ear. What'll I do? He said, don't answer. Another man walked in the doctor. He said, you're going to live to be 60. He said, I am 60. What'd I tell you? Man goes to the doctor. He says, doctor, I'm having trouble at home with my love life. What'll I do? He said, take off 20 pounds. Run 10 miles a day. Man calls him 2 weeks later. Doc, took off the 20 pounds. I've been running 10 miles a day. Well, how's your love life? I don't know. I'm 140 miles away. I went to the doctor. I said, doc, it hurts when I do that. He says, don't do that. He says, get undressed. I'll examine you. I'm standing there naked. He says, go over the window. Stick your tongue out the window. I said, for what? He said, I'm mad at my neighbor. The doctor puts a stethoscope to my heart. I said, doc, how do I stand? He said, that's what puzzles me. I said, Doc, my foot hurts. What'll I do for it? He said, limp. He says to me, you're pregnant. I says, how does a man get pregnant? The usual way, a little wine, a little dinner. Man goes to a psychiatrist. He says, nobody talks to me. He says, next. What a crowd tonight. Another fellow goes to a psychiatrist. He says, you're crazy. He says, I want a second opinion. You're ugly, too. There's a whole new world today. Ethnic jokes. They're around today. They have a new Polish jigsaw puzzle. One piece. Two Santa Clauses. Which one is Polish? The one with the Easter basket. You ever see a Polish guy whistle for a cab? Taxi? They sent the Polish terrorist to blow up a car. He burned his lips on the exhaust pipe. A Polish man buys a zebra for a pet. You know what he calls him? Spot. On Halloween, two Polish guys with burned faces. They were bobbing for French fries. Are you Polish? I'll talk slower. He had his hair cut in a pet shop. Look at that. They teach a Polish man how to run a helicopter. He's up around 800 feet. Down it comes. What happened? Got chilly up there. Turned out the fan. One more. Polish man has a bandage on each ear. I said, what happened? He said, I was ironing and the phone rang. What happened to your other ear? Had to call a doctor. We just got the news a bomb fell on Italy. It slid off. Why does the new Italian Navy have glass-bottom boats? So they can see the old Italian Navy. I have fun. I love the Italian people. During World War II, an Italian girl hid me in her cellar. It was on Mulberry Street in New York. In Israel, a fella drives up to the cop. Can I park here? He says, no. How about these other cars? They didn't ask. Little Jewish lady walks in the record store. Do you have a low dolly? The man says, what speed? She says, hello, dolly. Little Jewish man gets hit by a car. They're waiting for the ambulance. The cop takes his jacket off, covers him. He says, you're comfortable? He says, I make a nice living. Miami Beach, the little Jewish grandmother is supposed to take care of the Jewish grandson by the water. She turns her head away. A wave washes the kid way out. They call the lifeguard, the helicopter, the police. They finally grab the little kid. They bring him in. They pump him out for an hour. The kid starts to breathe again. The grandmother says he had a hat. love this crowd. Man needs a lawyer, picks up the phone book, sees a law firm, Schwartz, 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 and Schwartz. Calls up, I'd like to talk to Mr. Schwartz. Not in today's playing golf. He's all right. Then let me talk to Mr. Schwartz. He's no longer with us, he's retired. He's all right. Then let me talk to Mr. Schwartz. He's in Detroit, won't be back for a week. He's all right, and let me talk to Mr. Schwartz. He's just speaking. Fellow from Evanston, Georgia, Israeli Army. He's in the Army 3 days. He asked for a 3-day pass. Colonel said, what are you, a nut from Evanston? You're in the Army 3 days? Now you dare ask for a 3-day pass? You have to earn it. You must do something spectacular. Next day, he comes back driving an Arab tank by himself. The colonel says, how did you do it? He said, I took one of our tanks and went towards the Jordan. I saw one of their tanks come towards me. He put up his white flag. I put up my white flag. I went out. I spoke to the guy. I said, you want to get a 3-day pass? Yeah, we exchanged tanks. I feel good. I played golf today. I broke 70. A lot of clubs to break. I picked up my club. I swung. I missed the ball. A piece of dirt came up. Tried it again. Swung again. Missed the ball again. Another piece of dirt came up. Two little ants climbed on the ball. I said, let's get up here before we get killed. Wherever you go, people hit me right here. They say, take weight off. Go to Jack LaLanne. Go to Vic Tanney. They take weight off with their equipment, and it works. A friend of mine went there, took off 20 pounds in 1 week. The machine tore his leg off. I feel good, though, really. I just came on a pleasure trip. Took my mother-in-law to the airport. My very dear friends Marge and Rocky DiCrescendo here tonight, celebrating the 20th payment on a new refrigerator. Married 25 years, they're here with their 26-year-old son. Great kid, played football this time, you know. And I, when I was in high school, I played football, but the coach didn't like me. I was a wise guy with the jokes. Kept me on the bench all season. Last game of the season, the crowd hollers, we want Youngman. We want Youngman. He don't even look at me. 20 minutes later, we want Youngman. We want Youngman. He's okay, Youngman. Get out there. See what they want. If my mother knew I was doing this for a living, she'd kill me. She thinks I'm selling dope. Had a rough night, folks. There was a girl knocking my hotel room door all night long. Finally, I let her out of the room. I'm stopping at the Hyatt Regency O'Hare near the airport, you know. But a lovely room and bath there. Little inconvenient, they're in two different buildings. That hotel is elegant. Room service has an unlisted number. My room is so small, the mice are hunchback. I put the key in the door. I broke the window. Two people check into the Watergate Hotel, a honeymoon couple. They get to their suite. The bride is very nervous. What's the matter, darling? Maybe the place is still being bugged. He looks behind the curtain, the shades, looks behind the piano, picks up the carpet. Aha! A disc with four screws. Takes them out, puts them in his pocket. Next morning, the manager knocks on the door. Mr. Leopoldi, did you enjoy the suite? Perfect, he said. Did you like the dinner we sent you and your lovely bride and the champagne? Perfect. How do you like the Watergate Hotel nowadays? He says, this is the best service I have ever had. Why do you keep asking me questions? He says, a couple below you complained a chandelier fell on him. Or... woman taking a shower bath. She hears the doorbell ring. Who's there? Blind man. She runs out, opens the door. Where should I put these blinds, lady? I'm downtown. I said to her, lady, you know where Michigan Avenue is? She says, yeah. And she walked away. One fellow said, give me $10 till payday. I said, when is payday? He said, you ought to know. You're the one that's working. One fellow said, I haven't eaten in 2 days. I said, you should force yourself. One fellow said, I haven't tasted food all week. I said, don't worry, it tastes the same. One guy says, give me $300 for a cup of coffee. I said, coffee's a quarter. He said, I want to drink in Brazil. Give these fellas money, they gamble. One fellow says, I played a great horse the other day. Took 7 horses to beat him. I played a horse so slow, the jockey kept a diary of the trip. Jockey hit the horse. Horse turned around and said, what are you hitting me for? There's nobody behind us. That's the first time I ever saw a horse start from a kneeling position. He was so late getting home, he tiptoed in the stable. I don't mind when the horse slept at the post. I don't mind when the horse comes up to me in the grandstand and asks, which way did they go? But when I see the horse, I bet on it, the $2 winner playing another horse in the same race. Cheer up back there, cheer up. I know a guy in Fort Worth with 100,000 head of cattle. Nobody, just a head. I'm in the lobby here tonight. I found a man's hand in my pocket. I said, what do you want? He said, I want a match. I said, why don't you ask for it? I don't talk to strangers. Little jeweler has a shop. He stutters. A man rushes in. Take this watch. Put a new band on. Clean the glass. Fix it up. I'll be back in half hour and slams the door. And the jeweler looks up and says, come in. Good night, all. Thank you very much.